Welcome back to Hill, welcome to 2025, and we are off to a flying start. Let's start with GT50 and the starter generator testing. Let's head over to the lab. Just before Christmas, we got the very first Hill starter generator unit onto the high-speed test rig here in the high-speed test lab. The very first order of the day was essentially to get the system properly aligned, properly set up, and then to drive using the prime mover, the generator side of the starter generator, all the way through the normal operating speed range. In the early part of this month, we've run from zero all the way up to 40,000. We've got the last 10,000 to go once we've got this thing aligned slightly better, but that doesn't really pose any significant problems for us. So we're just tidying up some of the mechanical details on the rig itself, and that should let us run through the full range. In the meantime, Genu has been characterising the electrical characteristics of the starter generator hardware. So measuring all of the fundamental characteristics of the motor that we then need to tune our sophisticated control system on the PMU hardware. Once that's done, we can then drive the starter generator under its own power as both a motor and then process the power that's generated at high voltage into useful 28 volts DC. Genu's doing that work right now, and while he's doing that, we've got the first MGU stripped down back in the metrology lab, and we're re-measuring all of the components to see if there's been any changes while we've been running it through the operating speed range. And then we can get it back together and carry on with the testing to allow us to start the electrical phase of testing. What that means is with the control system then fully calibrated, we can run this as a starter and a generator and prove that we can generate 10 kilowatts and we can drive 8.5 kilowatts as a motor to get GT50 started. Let's move on now to the speed reduction gearbox, module 4 of the GT50 engine, where we're busily turning a great big pile of these into a great big pile of these. What you can see on the board behind me is the current batch of components that are busily going through the machine shop. One of the key jobs that Mark and his team are having to do at the moment is coordinating some of the subcontract processes with the stuff that we're doing in-house to make sure we've got all of the components that we need here on time to test the GT50 speed reduction gearbox. Over the course of the last week or so, we've had the last few elements of the test rig itself starting to come in. So over the course of the next week or so, we'll be starting to build the actual test rig that these gearboxes go onto. Let's nip out onto the shop floor and I'll show you some of the bits that we've been working on. First set of components I can show you here. This is the input and the output stub shafts that connect to the freewheel drive unit. These have been machined from solid bar. The output shaft is just awaiting a boring operation in the center, and the input shaft is ready to go out to have its spline teeth machined on the inside and outside faces so it can transmit that load. Many of these components, as I said a moment ago, have got up to 30 different operations in them to make them. So it's a constant logistical nightmare managing all of these things in one-offs and two-offs and three-offs through the shop floor. The other components that we've got here, I showed you some of these just before we broke up for Christmas, are the two sides of the speed reduction gearbox casing. So this is essentially a metal rapid prototype version that we've done in aluminium that's then been anodized, black anodized for corrosion protection. These would be cast in practice, but while we were waiting for the casting facility to be online, we've just rapid prototyped them as an analogy to that process. This is the second set that are awaiting machining. We've already done the first ones. Let's go and have a look at those. So here's the forward half of the speed reduction gearbox casing before we were machine it. And then once we've machined it, this is what it looks like. So it's a lot lighter for starters, but all of the faces where we have to connect other mechanical components, we machine back the aluminium to give us precise control of the circularity and the dimensions of each of these ports. So we've got the engine mounting points, lubrication ports, that's where the power takeoff shaft comes out, the drive shaft comes out, and that's where the power turbine goes in. And then again, on the inside, you can see we've dressed the flange faces, and all of these critical pickup dimensions have been machined to the tolerances we need to be able to hold everything precisely where we want it for the engine. And with the exception of the last couple of big fabrications, which are due in on Monday or Tuesday next week, we've now got all of the bits and pieces that we need in stock, ready to build the speed reduction gearbox test rig. So over the course of the next couple of weeks, I would say we'll make a start on putting that rig together ahead of the completion of all of the speed reduction gearbox components themselves, ready to start the testing. One of the surprisingly challenging areas of GT50 to get just right is the design of the fuel spray nozzles that pierce through the back of the combustion chamber here. The challenge is we have to be able to pass fuel through each of these nozzles from around 0.35 US gallons per hour to around 3.5 US gallons per hour, a factor of 10 difference in flow rates. And for all of those flow rates, we have to be able to atomize the fuel down to 20 micron particle sizes to ensure the characteristics of the burn are right in the combustion chamber itself. And we've also got the ignition capability for all atmospheric conditions that the aircraft's likely to fly in. Over the course of the last 2 months, really, we've been conducting an extremely sophisticated period of development, optimizing a range of geometries and analyzing a range of geometries so that we can build a handful of sizes of spray nozzles here that cover all of the likely scenarios that we'll encounter during development. We have today finished that work, and we're now on to the business of producing these tiny components to super, super tight tolerances and surface finishes to allow us to provide reliable and consistent uniform fuel flow around the GT50 combustion system. Those components are going to be signed off and released for production next week, I would imagine, and then we'll be back onto the combustion rig over on Rufus there to get the flow balance in each of those nozzles, the cone angle right, the atomization right, and then on to combustion testing again prior to those things finding their new home inside GT50.